Creating a stunning page that reflects your brand comes down to fine-tuning little details, including spacing. And earlier, certain knowledge of web design languages is important for that process. But with Foxify, you just need to understand the core concepts to bring your ideas to life. Like margin and padding, for example. Welcome to Foxify Tutorials. In this video, let's take a look at these basic styling concepts and see how you can edit margin and padding in Foxify Smart Page Builder. You can use the timestamps listed to navigate this video. Now, let's begin. First, let's get to know about margin and padding. From the center out, each page element consists of content, padding, a border, and margin. The content of the element is where text and images appear. The margin property controls the space outside an element, and the padding property controls the space inside an element. These CSS concepts share some similarities, but how they change the look of your page elements is very different. To further distinguish between the two, let's learn when you should use margin and padding in Foxify. So, let's access Foxify's page editor. Here I will create a new home page using a pre-made template named Wedding Ring. Margins are the spacing surrounding an element. So they are not actually a part of the element, but they push other elements further away. Therefore, margins can be used to create spacing between elements of the same container. For example here, you can adjust the spacing by simply dragging or inserting a pixel value in the Styles tab. What's interesting is that you can either set them all up in one declaration or do adjust each of the four margins separately. In Foxify, you can also change the unit of measure of your margins and padding. We offer pixels, rem, m, and percentage. Or like in this custom section, if I want to create more space between the image and the content below, I will adjust the bottom margin of the image. Or I can use margins to move one element. For example, I want my icons here to be more centered. Padding controls how much breathing room exists within the element. And the most common use of padding is to add space between the content and its border. So, if your element is a button, like this one, your padding is what makes sure the content inside, which is Shop Now, isn't tightly hugged by its borders. For example, if there were no padding, the button would look positively awkward. When you increase the size of your padding, you actually are increasing the size of the block within the border. Similar to margins, you can set padding on all sides by dragging in the editor, or insert the values in the style settings. Margins and padding affect how your page looks on various devices, which is why you can easily switch between screen sizes in the editor to see how elements respond. Now that you've got an idea of what these CSS properties can do, go ahead and use them to create your stunning Foxify pages. If you like our video, make sure you give the video a thumbs up and hit subscribe so you won't miss any other future videos. Thank you for watching.